individual number.
But what happens when we have significant figures in calculations? So when we look at significant figures in calculations, we have to come up with another set of rules to express these. And there's two types of scenarios that we have. The first is addition and subtraction. And for addition and subtraction, the resulting number will have the same number of decimal places as the measurement with the fewest decimal places. So if, for example, we were taking the number 20.42 and we're going to add to that 1.322, and we're also going to add to that 83.1. When we add these together, we get a total of 104.842. The question is, how many significant figures do we list for this particular problem? When we have addition and subtraction, you have to look at the decimal place of the least significant. So in this case, the 83.1, we have the tenths place that's going to be the least significant. So as a general rule of thumb, I find it easiest to draw a line down like this, because this value right here has the least significant decimal place. So that means the tenths place has to be the significant figure that we're going to report. So in this case, our value needs to be rounded to 104.8. And the reason for that is because our 83.1 is going to restrict the significant figures here. The second rule comes into play when we have multiplication or division. And the rule's a little bit different. The result contains the same number of significant figures as the measurement with the fewest significant figures. So for example, if we're doing an area calculation, when we calculate the area, we're multiplying two things together. So let's just say our area is going to equal 6.221 centimeters times 5.2 centimeters. If we multiply these together, the product is 32.3492 centimeters squared. We now have to look at the number of significant figures for each of the two things we're multiplying together. In this case, we have four significant figures for the first number and two significant figures for the second number. That means this 5.2 centimeters is going to limit our final result. So this 32.3492 needs to be expressed to two significant figures, and our value that we're going to list is 32 centimeters squared. If we have more than two numbers multiplied together, or if we're dividing more than two numbers, it's always going to be the least significant figures for whichever one is listed here. So if you have 10 numbers and the least significant is two significant figures, your final product is going to have two significant figures. We'll go over many of these examples in class, And as we do problems throughout the entire course, we're going to keep in mind all our significant figure values. But these come into play most when we're looking at